Hi everyone, welcome to our channel Stockman Closet. Thanks a lot for your love and support. And please hit the subscribe button if you haven't already and also click the bell icon to get the new video notification. Today I'm sharing pleated ruffle technique. It's one of my favorite and can be used as embellishment in various projects. I'll show you the easiest way to make it, so let's get started. Take a strip of fabric. For width, take double the required width plus seam allowance. For length, decide the size of pleat, like I'm making 1 inch ruffle. For each pleat, there will be 3 layers. So multiply ruffle size with 3. Here I'll get 3 inch as 3 multiplied by 1 is 3. Now multiply 3 by the required length, which is 5 inch, as I'm just giving you an example. 3 multiplied by 5 is 15 inch. So I need 15 inch long fabric strip to get 5 inch ready length with 1 inch pleat size. I hope it makes sense. So here is the fabric strip, 3 inch wide and 15 inch long. Fold the fabric by half in width and iron it. Make a stitch on the top. You can also use overlocking. So I have overlocked the half portion and you can also use a straight stitch like this. To make knife pleat, I have taken this paper strip. This is 1 inch wide as I'm making 1 inch pleat. If you want 2 inch pleat, then take 2 inch wide paper strip. So I'll just start making the pleat. Just place the paper and fold the fabric. Now pull out the paper and make a stitch. Again place the paper and repeat the same process. Two layers of fabric are on the top of paper and one is underneath. In knife pleats, all the pleats face the same direction. Isn't it the easiest way to make pleats? So knife pleat ruffle is ready. Now next is box pleat ruffle. I've taken 3 inch wide and 40 inch long strip. Fold the fabric by half in width and make a top stitch or finish it with overlocking. Now again I'll use the same paper strip to make box pleats. It's just in this two pleats will face each other. So place the strip, overlap the double layer of fabric, pull out the paper strip and pin it up. Now repeat the same process with pleat facing inwards. Again pin it up. Now similarly make rest of the pleats. You can directly make pleats while stitching. I'll show you. So box pleat ruffle is ready. I'm totally obsessed with this technique. It makes pleating really a fun project. Do try it and share your reviews in the comment section. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you like this video, and if you do, please give it a thumbs up and do subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you soon. Till then, take care. Bye bye.